Constructing buildings of any kind is a very detail-oriented process. No matter if you're constructing a medical facility, car dealership, or manufacturing operation, there are very definite steps that must be taken to ensure the safety of construction workers, employees, and patrons of the future building. While specifications and permits can vary from project to project, the general order of operations in any construction project remains the same. When working with an experienced construction firm, you can be sure that your project will adhere to a fixed process that grows through these same steps. What are those steps? Let's take a look. 1. Preparing the site. After obtaining your initial building permits, your construction project will commence by clearing and excavating the land upon which you want to build. This includes removing any trees, boulders, or other obstacles that are in the way of construction. A site perimeter is also set up. 2. Site survey and layout. The layout survey is the process of interpreting the building plans and marking the position of the proposed structure on the ground surface using survey equipment, such as the total station, so that excavation for the foundation can be carried out. This process ensures that the foundation of the building is set according to the design. 3. Excavation. Once the layout survey is finished, it's time to do the excavation. Excavating depends on your preferred foundation for the isolated footing, combined footing to mat foundation, or raft foundation. Upon choosing the specific foundation, the excavators are deployed on the site. Number 4. Compacting and laying of PCC. Now you want your building to be strong, and these couple of steps are the most important in that aspect. Compaction is defined as the process of increasing soil density by removing air voids. Normally, it's done by adding crushed gravels, and the final compacted layer has to be 95% of max dry density. Then a layer of PCC, also called plain concrete cement, is laid on top of the layer. Number 5. Preparation of foundation. After the PCC is laid, it's time to start working on the foundation. The foundation beams are focused on first. Frameworks for the beams are set up first, then it is poured with concrete, also ensuring a proper and standard concrete cover. Starter bars for columns should also be installed accordingly before concrete pouring. Number 6. Concreting of foundations. After the beams are done, now the whole foundation is concreted. To ensure a proper spread of the concrete, it should be vibrated. Remember those column starter bars. They should be concreted with proper coverage to continue the work on column reinforcement. 7. Working on the columns. After the stub columns have been finished being concreted, give the concrete time to completely dry before painting the columns with at least 2 coats of bituminous paint. Bitumen paint absorbs soil moisture and stops seepage into the concrete foundation. 8. Define a perimeter. Solid blocks are set up along the perimeter of the whole project to define a proper boundary between what's inside and what's outside of the project. 9. Another compacting. As the foundation structure meets their end, it's time to start backfilling and compacting. They're done partially so that the required level according to the design is met. 10. Concreting and setting up tie beams. After backfilling and compacting are done, the design drawings are pulled out to start the preparation and installment of tie beams. Of course, this should be followed after concreting the compacting level. The proper cover should be used for the tie beam formwork. After the tie beam formwork, grab slab mesh is installed and concreted. Number 11, going up. Now, as all the substructure components of the building are done, the building will now start to rise with the installment of columns. The roadbusters get busy during this step to finish all the rebar works, shuttering, or formworks. Of course, the drawings are pulled out to figure out the proper places of the columns. Number 12, beam and slab works. The earlier step will sort out the ground floor columns, so next beams and suspended slab reinforcement activities follow. Remember, from now on, it's all about the design of the project, so most of it is done while the design drawing is open to ensure everything is going according to plan. The formworks and shuttering of the beams and slabs should be anchored properly before it's been concreted. The last 2 steps are then repeated to get the structural frame or the core and shell of the structure. After that, the project is handed to the architectural finishing department. And that's the end of this video. I will see you at another time in another video. Stay in the loop.